Welcome to Catherine's tutorial. In this video, we learn about excretory system of earthworm in detail. Excretory system of earthworm. As we already learned in the previous video about the structure of circulation, structure of digestion, so all these organs are very well, developed, but they are not complex in their structure. There is no specialized structure to perform excretion, but there are simple structure which can do the complete function of excretion in case of earthworm. They don't have a complex organ like other or group of organism, like especially mammals or humans. They doesn't have a specified kidney or they doesn't have a specified organ to do their function. Instead, they have simplified structure that can perform the complete see in detail. So before getting into this topic, we should know what is excretion. Excretion is nothing but elimination of metabolic waste from the body, is known as excretion. Okay, and to do the function of excretion, there are organs, and those organs constitute the excretory system of any organism. We'll just see what are the organs are present in earthworm excretory system. The earthworm releases two types of waste, carbon dioxide and nitrogenous waste. Dioxide is eliminated, it is eliminated through the skin. There is no defined respiratory organ. Instead, in earthworm, the skin functions as respiratory system, where they have small pores on the skin but always kept moist. That enhances the exchange of gases between the environment and to the organism. And for the elimination of nitrogenous waste, they need a kind of excretory system. So what type of excretory system they have? We'll just see in detail what are the organs are present here. There are three types of nephridia. They have specialized structure known as nephridia to perform the function of excretion in earthworm. What are the three types of nephridia? They are nothing but septal nephridia. It is also known as typical nephridia. The next type of nephridia is integumentary nephridia. Integumentary nephridia. The third type is known as pharyngeal nephridia. Pharyngeal nephridia. So these are the three different type of nephridias found in excretory system. These three nephridias will perform the function of excretion. So we'll just see one by one along with the diagram. So these are the Bruce, are the outer layer that contains the skin, which has all the numerous pores which can do the function of excretion. Okay, here we will draw the digestive system. So it starts with the mouth and a buccal cavity, followed by pharynx. Gizzard, followed by stomach, and they have intestine. So we'll divide them into segments where you can able to identify the structures. Now we'll just see one by one. The first type of nephridia, what we have learned, is septal nephridia. So septal nephridia is also known as typical nephridia. Why it is known as typical? Because it does the exact function of excretion in case of earthworm. So that is why they are known as typical nephridia. That is, they perform the function of excretion. So typical nephridia. So the septal nephridia, so we'll just see from where you can able to find the septal nephridia. It is present from the 15th segment onwards. Imagine it is a 15th segment I have drawn here. So 15th segment, from the 15th segment you can able to find the septal nephridia till the last segment of this organism. We can able to find till the last segment of the organism. These nephridias present on the like septal region, that is septum. It represents the segments. You can able to see them in the segments of the organism. So imagine it is a 15 segment. On one side you can able to find nephridia, which is present on both the sides of the organism. So here also you can see nephridia, and this side also you can able to see nephridias. So they are numerous in number. So on both the sides in each segment you can able to find these nephridias, and here on both the sides it is around 40 to 50 in number on one side. I'm just drawing to represent this nephridial structure. Okay, so these nephridia are known as septal nephridia. And here the septal nephridia, when you take only one side of the segment, okay, if you take only this segment alone, it is around 40 to 50 nephridias you can able to find. So you can able to find 40 to 50 nephridia, okay, but if you count as a whole, it is a complete segment. If you take into account, you can able to find nearly 80 to 100 nephridia in septal region, in each septal region. So the number is around 80 to 100 in each segment of the septum. It starts from the 15th segment and it extends till the last segment. This nephridia, that is septal nephridia, contains one more specified structure that perform the complete function of excretion, is nothing but nephridia. Okay, they contains nephridia. We'll just draw the diagram of nephridia so that you can able to understand how they perform the function of secretion. These nephridias are, they have a funnel shaped structure. It acts like a mouth, and followed by the neck region, and followed by the a long coiled structure. You can able to find a long coiled structure which opens to a small, through a small opening. Okay, this small opening is known as nephridiopore. So through this pore only the metabolic waste has been eliminated. And here you can able to find a funnel shaped structure known as nephrostome. This is known as the neck region of the nephrostome, and these nephrostome has cilia like structures, small hair like structures on the outer side. We can able to find small hair like structures on the outer side which regulates the movement of substances. The inner region also contains cilia that regulates the movement of substances through this structure. Okay, so this region is known as, this is cilia, and this is lower lip, this is upper lip. So this is the structure of, this is the structure of nephridia that is present in septal region. Okay, so it has an opening known as funnel shaped structure known as nephrostome. It has a small pore that opens outside to eliminate the metabolic waste, that is known as nephridiopore. Okay, it contains upper lip and lower lip, and it has also got cilia inside it, so that it allows the movement of particles inside. It absorbs whatever is needed to maintain the homeostatic mechanism in earthworm. The remaining substances has been eliminated through the nephridiopore. Okay, so these typical nephridia, septal nephridia, has a structure known as nephridia, okay, which does all the function of absorbing the needed materials and eliminating the waste outside the body, that is metabolic waste. Okay, integumentary nephridias starts from third segment onwards. Integumentary nephridia starts from the third segment and extends till the last segment of the organism. Till the last segment you can able to find this integumentary nephridia. Why it is known as integumentary? Because they attach to the body wall or skin of the organism. You can able to find them attached with the body wall or skin of the organism. And one more important thing, this is known as endonephric, which means they dump the waste into the intestine. So the metabolic waste is dumped inside the intestine, from where it is taken to the outside the body through some other structure. So this is known as endonephric nephridia, because they dump the waste in the intestine. The waste has been dumped, that is metabolic waste has been dumped in the intestine. That is why they have got a name endonephric. These integumentary nephridia starts from third segment onwards and ends till the last segment, or runs till the last segment of the organism. Each segment, okay, each segment contains around 200 to 250 nephridia. The number of nephridia per segment is around 200 to 250 per segment. You can able to find this amount of nephridia per segment. And one more important thing, when this nephridia reaches the clitella region, okay, I'm just drawing the clitellum here. Now it is 15, 16 and 17 segment. The clitellum starts from 14 segments. So 14, 15, 16 and 17. I am just thickening this area to differentiate the clitellum. So in this region, that is the clitellum, that is present between clitellum, which is present between 14th to 17th segment. Okay. This particular segment has around 2500 nephridia. Okay. So the clitella region contains around 2000 to 2500 nephridia, and these nephridias are present more in number in clitellum. That is why the clitellum is also known as forest of nephridia, because it is more in number when they reach the clitella region. So that is why it is known as forest of nephridia. That is especially clitellum when you take integumentary in detail. These integumentary nephridias are also known as exonephric. Okay, why it is known as exonephric? What do they do actually? These exonephric, exo means outside. They eliminate the waste outside the body. They throw the waste outside the body. Imagine these are folded structures which opens outside through a small pore. Okay, so this small pore opens on the skin region. I'm just drawing the segments here. It opens on the skin region where you can able to find the segments of the body here. So this pore eliminates the waste outside the body of organism. That is why it is known as exonephric nephridia. And one more important structure what we have to learn is about the third type of nephridia. This is first type, this is second one, and third is known as pharyngeal nephridia. So why it is known as pharyngeal nephridia? They are present from the segment of 4, 5 and 6 where you can able to find pharynx. Imagine it is a 4th segment, 5th segment and 6th segment. On this side you can able to find this nephridia on both the sides. These are pair. Okay, these are 3 pair in number. These nephridias are known as pharyngeal nephridia. So these pharyngeal nephridia are found from the 4, 5 and 6th segment, and these structures are known as endonephric. Endonephric means they dump the waste into the buccal cavity of the organism. The waste has been dumped inside the buccal cavity. But here in case of septum, it is dumped inside the intestine, it is dumped inside the buccal cavity. Let us learn about one more important structure known as chlorogogen cells. These cells are known as cells, they are also known as Y cells. They are known as liver of earthworm. So it does the function, that is the liver does in vertebrates. Okay, whatever function is done by the liver in vertebrates, all this function are done by this particular group of cells in case of earthworm. That is why it is also known as liver of earthworm. Okay, and these Y cells, Y gives the term yellow. These chlorogogen cells looks yellow in color because of the presence of specialized structures or specialized cells known as chlorogosomes. So these are the special cells which are present inside them that gives them the yellow color. That is why these cells are known as Y cells. What is the function of these chlorogogen cells? They are found in coelom actually. These cells are found in the coelomic fluid of organism, which neutralize the toxins. It neutralizes the toxin which enters inside the organism. It also stores glycogen. So these are the major function done by the chlorocogen cells. Okay, these are specialized structures found in the earthworm. They are found in the coelomic fluid of the organism. Okay, I am just repeating again. There are three types of nephridia I can able to find in the earthworm that does the function of excretion. The first type is septum, where I can able to find the segmental region, and the second type is integumentary, where they found on the attached to the skin region, and third type is pharyngeal nephridia, found on the region of 4, 5 and 6, where you can able to find the pharynx. That is why they are given with the name pharyngeal. These group of nephridia are also known as endonephric, because they dump the waste inside the intestine of the organism, and these pharyngeal nephridia are known as endonephric again, because they dump the waste inside the buccal cavity of the organism. But here in case of this integumentary nephridia, they dump the waste outside the body through a small pore known as exonephric. Okay, and apart from that, chlorocogen cells, and these chlorocogen cells are specialized structures present in earthworm that neutralizes the toxins, okay, that enters inside the body of organism. By the next class, we'll discuss about the male reproductive system of earthworm in detail. Thank you.